18.
They don't know me, son.
Get it. 19.
They don't know me, son.
Yeah. 20. You got some more in you. Get it again. Come on. We want to see it. Good. 22.
Who's going to carry the boats and the logs?
So, Saturday, 4 a.m. Day one, run one. We just heading out now. I overslept slightly. Didn't have breakfast. Haven't had a drink. So I'm doing this fasted and dehydrated. Not a great start. Idiot. But, yeah. Gonna get it out of the way anyway. That's run number one out of the way. We did 6.5 kilometers in a total of 39 minutes. We haven't quite got the route dead on yet. We finished about a 5 minute walk from home, but that'll be a nice cool down. We're gonna go home, stretch, have breakfast and hydrate. That's the most important thing. And then we go again at 8 a.m. for run number two. So I'll see you then. So I've had some porridge and a banana and a bottle of electrolytes, and as you can see, I'm now curled up on my sofa. I'm gonna have a nap. It's 5:25. It's weird, like I didn't feel tired finishing the run, but once I cooled down, just my body was like, yeah, you need sleep, mate.
Bruh.
Little nap, then we go for run two at just before 8 a.m. 22 past seven, I'm back in my workout gear, ready for run number two. I've only slept, oh my God, I can't even talk. It's 7:22, gonna be going out for run number two now. Gonna try a little bit of a faster pace. Run one felt a bit weird. Running so slowly, we were doing about 7 minutes per kilometer. So it's probably, I don't know, 8 minutes per mile or something, whatever. My left hip started to feel really dodgy, so...
Oh, boo-hoo! Let me play a sad song for you on the world's smallest violin.
I don't know if that was down to my gait or if it was just the cold, but I need to play around with it. I don't want it to be aggravating me and causing problems for another 11 runs. So I'm going to try and go a little bit faster, see if it clears up. Have a bit of a warm up and stretch before I go out as well. That's run number two out the way. It is 8:30. I've refueled with a protein shake and necked about a liter of water. I'm just on the way to the shop now to go and get some paracetamol and ibuprofen because I know for sure that I'm going to need it at the very least when I get to about halfway mark, which is run number six of 12. But we're 12 kilometers in, so 8 miles in total. The last run took us about 36 minutes, running at about a 5:30 minute per kilometer pace. That's roughly where I want to be keeping the rest of the runs for the majority of this. Obviously by the end of it, as I'm fatigued and the muscles start to, ligaments and tendons and joints all start screaming for me to stop, that's definitely going to get slower and slower. But the main thing is to just finish this and get through it. It's 10 past 10 now, so I've got a little bit of time before my next run. I'm gonna have a nice warm bath and stretch, just so that I'm not seizing up too early on into the 12 runs. 11 o'clock, just got out of the bath, so it's time to stretch, get all loosey-goosey, ready for run number three. There's some fresh homemade ginger root tea that I'm about to have. It's still really hot. it's like boiled the cup and I've just burnt my finger. And I have one of these Eat Natural protein bars as well. As a little snack. It's 11:15 and my cat has decided to come say hello to offer her support. Hello. Hopefully the ginger root tea is going to help settle my gut. So while I'm running, it's not, you know, I don't feel like I need to go to the toilet every 5 minutes. Oh dear. That's going in, Kat. I'm not cutting that. You're going to be on YouTube. Needy bitch. Hell, that's strong. Tastes alright, but that ginger hits, man. I hope this is worth it. It's 11:55. I've been itching to get out on this third one. So I'm heading out now. Another 6.5 kilometers to clock up. Doing this one solo. So I'm gonna have my music for company. I'm feeling good though. I don't feel too sore yet. I mean, I do run a little bit each week, but nothing this crazy. Not this amount of volume. So anywho, we'll see how we go. So that's run three. Done in a time of 33 minutes. So that's the fastest one so far.
That was legitness.
Yeah, it was.
But I'm not counting on getting any faster for any of the other runs. Like, I think if I hit that pace for another one or two, I'll be over the moon. 33 minutes, 6.5 kilometers. So again, gonna refuel, rest. Now might be a good time to have a nap, considering I'm going to have 4, 8, 12 and then 4 a.m. again as my next four runs. So I'm going to be suffering with a lack of sleep over the next 12 hours, that's for sure. So food, nap. Lunch is served. So I have to say, I'm not feeling too bad. I'm feeling really good, like really energetic, really positive about the whole thing. My knees, my left knee and my left hip are starting to give me a bit of issues. Where I've had injuries in the past, meniscus tears and things, but it's something that's manageable. And even if I have to run the rest of these at a snail's pace, I'm going to finish it. I've started something, I've committed to it, and worst of all, I don't want to embarrass myself in front of everybody who's donated for the fundraiser, or seeing that I'm doing this and then I just cop out because of something bullshit like a little niggle in my knee. Like, nah, I'm not doing that. So I'm going so quickly in between these. It's coming up to 1 o'clock, so I've got 3 hours until the next one. Like, it's a joke. Oh well. Run number four. Feeling good. So we are heading over to my work over in Elstree and Boreham Woods. There's a nice little route that's literally 4 miles, just straight running, nice flat surface. So it's going to make a change and break up a little bit of the monotony with running around Ryslip, which is quite hilly, quite bumpy. The roads aren't too pleasant to run on. We're going to go do that. I also need to get a charger for my heart rate strap because it's going to die after this last run for sure. I would like to record as much of the run in through it as possible. We're just heading out now. It's going to take us about 25, 30 minutes to get there. And then we are going to be good to go. Nice straight run. I've got protein shake in the car with me, ready to refuel afterwards as well. So we'll see you in a bit. So we are at a village hotel. We're going to be running from here over to Costco, which is 3.6 miles. So I'm going to do a lap down the bottom of the business park and then come back up. That should cover the 400 meters that we're missing. Run number five, 8 p.m. Let's give it a whirl. Time for run number six. It's 12 a.m. This man. Getting out of bed was the hardest thing. Just so tired, but I'm going to have to just take it slow for this run. I'm not expecting to do it quickly, and I'm going straight back to bed after. Oh, I'm so dehydrated. Run number 6 is complete. I didn't settle into that run until about 5.5 kilometres in. But bitch time, we're on the home stretch. It's 1K to home and to the end of the run. So that's what's getting quite tough. My knees feel like they're being sliced off, sawed off with every step I take. It took us about 39 minutes, but that marks the end of the halfway point. The next run will take us into finishing a marathon distance over the 24-hour period. So I'm excited to get that done. That'll be a massive benchmark for us to hit. But I'm going to rehydrate with the Lucozade Sport and get back to sleep before the next run as quickly as possible. So it's 4 a.m. Run number 7. David Goggins has just gone live on Instagram, which has been helpful. Just a little bit of inspiration, words of motivation, just to endure the pain and crack on. Getting out of bed after each sleep's a little bit, it's getting harder and harder. But we're going to be back into the daytime soon. So hopefully my sleep cycle will sort itself out and getting up for the next runs won't be so difficult. Here you go. So we've literally just finished run number 9. I'm not, you can come in. Come here. You can come get in my video. Support the runs that we're doing. Do you think we're doing a good job? Yeah? Little man had an allergic reaction to some nuts earlier, so his eye's a bit swollen. Isn't it? Bless ya.
Yeah, it's a wee bit. It's good now.
It's getting better, isn't it?
Yeah.
So yeah, run 9, 3 to go. Literally can see the light at the end of the tunnel. My legs are so numb at the moment that I'm not actually feeling anything. All the pain's just sort of subsided. I think the next 3 runs are going to be very caffeinated, so I'm going to get some rest and then wake up and abuse the caffeine for the next 3, 12 miles. See you in a bit. Say bye.
Bye.
I'm stoked to get this. God, I can't even talk. I'm literally so tired. Like, I can't even put sentences together.
You want.
So the sun has come out for run number 10. We are so close to the finish line. The end is in sight and I am feeling good. I am stoked to get this done. I'm struggling to even think straight. I'm a bit delirious and deprived of sleep, but I am excited to finish this challenge. It's been a great journey so far. I can't wait to get the next 3 runs out of the way so I can enjoy a beer at the end. Gang. That's run 10. Done and dusted. We hit a 5 minute and 18 second kilometer pace. I think that's actually our fastest one to date, which, considering that was run 10, is all sorts of messed up. Only took us 34 minutes, so buzzing with that. Time to refuel and seriously shut up. Time to refuel, rehydrate. I might have a nap. I might just put my feet up for a bit. I don't know, but time to rest before the final 2 rounds. He's dead. I'm gonna have a coffee now just to wake myself up and then hit out and get on the road. It is bitter, you know, it's absolute bolted.
When it's cold outside, I'm gonna keep my black ass in this house, fuck today.
Which doesn't bode well for the 12 o'clock run. I think I'll be putting the trackies on as opposed to shorts. For anyone who knows me, I'm often the white guy found in winter wearing shorts. But even I might put on the trackies. Right, time to get the heart rate up. Bye. Another 35 minute run. And a 5:26 minute per kilometre pace. I need to eat as much as possible now. My legs are starting to get really tired and lethargic. I guess the lack of nutrients is zapping their energy. So I'm gonna have as much food as possible and a little bit of rest before the final run. 12 a.m. Monday morning, final run. Let's get it. That is run 12 of 12 done. We have done 4 miles every 4 hours for the last 48 hours and we are finished.
Hey, good job, guys. Let's just not come in tomorrow. Let's just take a day.
Finished. I am proud to have finished. My body is in bits, so I'm relieved that it's finished. But it's all been for the great cause, raising money for Mind's charity. So you can find the link in the bio on my Instagram page. But right now I'm going in, I'm having a beer, I'm having a shower, and I'm having a long old rest. Hello everybody, thanks for watching so far. I just wanted to do a roundup video basically on how the challenge went for us. All of the sort of different numbers, breakdown, sort of each run and everything. So ultimately, like, the first 4 or 5 runs felt really comfortable. Obviously I'm into fitness, I've got a sports background, I'm kind of used to running, but not that much distance. I suppose after run 6, would it be run 6? We did 4 miles, so yeah, after the fourth run, every step that I took was the furthest I'd ever been before.
This is it. This is what? If I take one more step, it'll be the farthest away from home I've ever been.
Up to run 5, everything felt really comfortable, really good. And then run 6 and 7, that was the 12 a.m. and 4 a.m. on the Sunday morning. So getting out of bed, sleep deprived, we were sore. Our knees from previous injuries where we've had meniscus tears and things were really achy. My feet were starting to swell up and you could feel the pain. It was quite uncomfortable and challenging. So getting out of bed in those conditions to go for a run when you're already sore, it would be really easy to quit. But I think by that point, we realized that actually we can still get the work done. Like, and we did. We managed to run those in about 40 minutes. They were slow runs, but we were able to get the workouts in. And this is the important thing and quite the magnificent thing is that it became more of a mental challenge at these points as opposed to a physical challenge. And I think what it goes to show is that actually, if you've got habits or that you want to curb, you know, if you want to go out and start losing weight or whatever it is, literally, it's on you. When you don't do it, it's all in your mind and it's a battle that you need to overcome first, because we could have easily just stopped as soon as things started to get difficult. Especially when, you know, run 6 and 7, you've still got a lot of runs ahead of you. Like, the end still isn't in sight and you don't know how much pain you're going to be in after each run. So genuinely, if there's things that you want to do, you need to take ownership of those goals and put yourself out there. It's not going to be comfortable, but that's the point.
Do it! Just do it! Don't let your dreams be dreams. Yesterday, you said tomorrow. So just do it! Make your dreams come true!
That's probably the big thing that I've taken from this, that anything I want to go out and achieve now, it's the battle is in my mind first and foremost. And after that, that's when it becomes a physical a battle to move forwards. I have to admit though, this morning, the main thing that hurts is my feet. Like, my feet are really swollen. My ankles are quite tender and painful. I'm not going to be training at all for the next 2 days. I'm just purely going to be trying to rest, relax and chill out, let my body recover. And then Wednesday evening, I'm going to aim to hit a really light full body weight workout just to build myself back into it. Because, you know, the intent, the volume of running that we did over the 2 days, the 48 hours was astronomical. Here's basically some numbers. I've broken everything down from the 48 hours. So we did 4 miles every 4 hours for 48 hours. That means that we covered a total distance of 76.8 kilometers or 48 miles in total over the 12 runs. We took over 84,000 steps and we burned over 6,000 calories just from running. So that doesn't include our metabolic rates. We clocked up an astounding 7 hours and 20 minutes of exercise accumulated over the 48 hours. And we managed to get a total elevation gain of 1,715 feet. So just over 500 meters, which means that our elevation gain was taller than the Empire State Building. So the main next challenge that I've set myself is, I actually set this in, I think it was December around Christmas time after a few drinks, I decided to sign up for the London to Brighton cycle. That's an 88 kilometer cycle there. So I've decided that I'm going to be doing that in September 2021. I have also decided that I'm going to be cycling back the day after. Rather than getting a coach or something back, I'm going to cycle there and cycle back. And in total, over those 2 days, I will cover the distance of the cycle element, the cycle discipline of an Ironman triathlon. So that's my next challenge, and that's the main focus really for my training. I'm still going to train weights, you know, 3 to 4 times a week. Strength training is really important, but that's my next focus. So that's going to be really good. Once I've done that, I only need to complete a 2 mile swim in its individual discipline before I can start piecing things together for an actual Ironman triathlon. So yeah, this has been a blast. I'm super proud of what I've accomplished. We managed so far to raise about £250 for Mind Charity, but that fundraising page is still open. So the link will be in the description if you want to go and donate. Every little helps, and it's a cause that's really close to my heart. So I'll be really grateful and appreciative for any donations that people make. And yeah, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Be sure to subscribe and hit the notification button if you want to get a notification for any of my future videos. I will see you.